Hello everyone. Today we're going to do another review. This time we're going to do on this new Knipex plier. This one is the 8201-200. It's a really nice plier. It's a little bit new on the Knipex line. They are somehow made to go against some of the vampire tools to take out the screws that the head are being broke and cannot be loosened with a regular screwdriver. So then you can use these pliers to loose them. I will show you in a minute how they do it. First, let's talk a little bit about the plier. They have the common button here that you push on Knipex plier, like the Cobra and things like that. It's the same mechanism. This one has 5 adjustable sections, adjustable position, so you can open for bigger screws. They have this nice design here, like thick in the middle, a little long, and then a little long here in the back, so you don't mess up your fingers. Especially when you open into the 5 position, it's still safe because it doesn't go more than that. So that makes it really nice. They do it by crossing this thing with these 2 sections here, which I'm going to mention is the only thing that I don't like it too much on this ply, because I'm not sure if I'm wrong, but these 2 arms here, I see them 2 weak. They, like I say, I may be wrong, but they look like a little weak, and sometimes even sound like a little weak. And then my fear is that one day this tool is in the floor or something, and then you put your feet to it, and if it may crash, or if you have it in a tool bag, and then your tool bag got pressed for something a little hard, and this thing may break, it may pop up. Because they, to me, they seems like a little thin. And sounds a little weird. I think that they could break. Like, for example, when you go to the vampire, you see they really thick. But besides that, I do love them. The other day I was doing a job and they saved my day, because the screw was totally a mess from a cabinet, and I remember having in my bag, and I took that screw like nothing. So they really, really, really good. So let's see. For example, this screw, let's say they have no head, and you have to take them out. You just grab them. You see, it's very, very deep, the screw. But if you go, you take a little bit of time, it will definitely do its part, and it will come out easy. And that's why they are good for them. The screw may damage a little bit around, but usually that screw will be thrown out once you take it out. But the tools are still perfect. We do nothing to the tool. Here they have a little bit section compared to the Cobra 2 to grab any screw, and you can make it go down very easy or loose down. Very, very easy. They're nice. I really, really like them. When you compare them to the Vampire, only have one more section. They grab very easy too. And when, but you see they close in the second section, they close together in the back. If you not be a little careful and you left your finger down, you may harm your fingers. In the first section, they don't do that. In the first section, they don't close to the end. But when you open to the wider one, they do. And that's a little bit not good from the Vampire. But the Vampire, they so nice on your hand too, that I really like them. They are more common, like the regular one that we usually use, like this one from Craftsman. But the Craftsman just got the regular front, so they just can't be used as a regular wrench. They nice too, this Craftsman. They grab very well on the front, and they can grab little ones too, and bigger one. It's good. Going back to the Vampire also can grab anything really, really tight. Let's say this screw there is really, really deep. You see how we move it? You see? Bring it out, you see, you see, you see. And this is a very tiny head of this screw. It does a good job. The same thing with this Canine Pex. They, honestly, they work almost the same. The Canine Pex can go really, really deep. Oh. Let's check now. Let's compare both of them. Which one can grab good? Like this one can grab very good, the Vampire. And the Canine Pex also can grab very good. They both can do almost the same thing to the same deep. Because the T is right there at the beginning of the tool. You have those nice teeth. And then here at the end too, here in the bottom. And we go to the Vampire. Also has the same thing. Really, really close to the end. And at the end too. It look like the one on the Vampire is a little bit wider than in the Canine Pex. The one in the front. That's more like a more bigger. In the side, I think the Canine Pex is it's more close to the front than the vampire. I like both of them. I recommend both of them. There is something nice about the Knipex on the size. The size feel good too. Even though this one is more easy on tight spaces and more easy, I guess, to get that screw. But this is a little long, so maybe it's a little bit more, I don't know, comfortable. But the fact that the Knipex can protect your fingers, it has a big advantage in there. The price are a little bit far away, but not much. This one could be like 30 to 40. This one you can find in 40 to 50. They're good. I will definitely take any of them. I probably will buy the Vampire for the only reason that I think the Vampire will last longer. I may be mistaken this, but maybe it will last longer because it's like a more solid tool than the Knipex. Even though Knipex has great metal, like I said at the beginning, I'm not quite sure of this wide gap here on this tiny metal. If you one day by mistake you put something heavy in it, it might break, but it could be not. But I still like a lot the Vampire. It's a Salix. This one is made in Japan. As you can see here, this one is made in Germany. So you can see over there. Okay, my friend. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. Thank you for your time.